Can we go way back? You began your professional writing career writing radio ads?
Yeah, I did. I used to write, I worked for two radio stations in New Zealand. I had to write 120 30-second radio commercials a week. Mm. And after about 30, you just run out of ideas. Mm. So it would always be thinking about carpet and thinking about gender reassignment. Thinking about whatever the product was.
I mean, I've been going on shows around the country and they go, of course, you were in the castle. Does anyone remember me in the castle? I was standing at the back in the kitchen in the final scene talking to Eric Banner for about 10 seconds
That's
on screen.
That's right, yes you were, beer in hand.
And we were just, I'd never met him before, and we were genuinely just having a conversation. And lip readers tell me, who've watched The Castle, that I was asking Eric Banner why his TV show was axed.
Is that true? Is that what you were talking
about? It's the first time you've talked about it.
Foolishly put the name Eggs in the title. Mm. So over the last 3 weeks I've been photographed with eggs, I've been asked to get into a giant egg cup, I've been asked to hit the top of Mick Malloy's head with a big spoon.
And you don't say no to any of this.
No, never. It's all good promotion. Just, you know, you've got to be careful what you call the film. We're glad we didn't call it Bad Anal Probe. Clearly, that was a bit of a mistake.
So you were directing, you were taking direction from Tony?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, for the first 3 weeks. And the balance of power shift. I don't know if I was taking direction. He was shuffling me off to dance class, stunt training and cocktail waitering.
Who is this? None of that was in the film. It was just...
You know, this is the other question you've probably been asked 1,000 times. You playing mixed love interest again?
I have been asked that question, so has Mick, so many times. And look, Rove, I'd just really like to settle this whole thing once and for all on national television and say, yes, Mick Malloy and I have been banging our brains out for years, and the next film we make together is simply going to be hardcore porn. So there you have it.
At last! Eureka!
An unlikely combination if you hadn't seen them together.
I mean, obviously you've got a lot of respect and chemistry with Mick Malloy, Bob.
I think it's all apparent up on screen, yes.
Thanks, Bob.
Chemical. You'll probably be writing for something for me and Bert next.
Do you think we're third behind the Terminator and Charlie's Angels? And it's kind of ironic for people who know me because we did a sketch of the Terminator 3 on the radio about 7 years ago. I remember at the time going, well, that could never really happen. There would never really be a Terminator 3. But, you know, Arnold is obviously laughing now. So much for your humour. He'll be saying.
I found, though, that when you work in the movie business, you, a number of things happen. Firstly, you become obnoxiously opinionated about everyone else's films. Secondly, when you're making a film, you don't want to go and see any other movies unless they're bad. You understand? You don't want to see a good film because it might be better. You become obsessed with box office figures for some reason. Mm. And also, you just talk about movies all the time. I actually had a friend of mine tell me she was pregnant, and I've gone, and she's saying, oh, I'm having a kid, and I've gone, when's that coming out? I actually used those words. Not in March, because that's The Matrix.